Hello students, today I am going to continue the lesson Unit 21 Nutrition and Health. In the last video, we discussed about the learning objectives and I gave you the short introduction about the lesson. Today's video, we are going to see the classes of nutrition. So first of all, I would like to tell you what is the major function of the nutrition in our human body. So the body uses nutrients for growth, maintenance and repair, and also the needs to take in about 40 varieties to function properly. So nutrition can be grouped into the 6 categories, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. So we can consider water as a nutrition also, but here they didn't include this. So these nutrients are classified according to their size and energy for our consumption. So among the 6 nutrition, carbohydrates, proteins and fats are considered as macronutrients because they make up a bulk of our diet. Okay, we used to eat a more of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. So vitamins and minerals are micronutrition because we would take them in a very little quantities, like salt, sugar, likewise. For example, one average person consumes about 9.5 liters of food and waters per day, but only an 1/8 of a spoon, that is vitamins and minerals. This doesn't matter that vitamins and minerals are unimportant. The key is only a small part of a car, but it's hard to get the car started without it, right? So likewise, the vitamins and minerals is also important to start a life of a human body. So let me tell you each and every examples, each and every classes of nutritions one by one. So the first class is carbohydrates. So we know carbohydrates is the organic compounds, which is composed of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So carbohydrate is an essential nutrition, which is also providing the major source of energy to the body. So here the non-starchy vegetables are also carbohydrates, but in lesser quantities. So carbohydrates are broadly classified into 2 forms based on their chemical structure, but they didn't give you here properly, but they might have glucose, sucrose, lactose, starch, cellulose are the examples of carbohydrates. So here the carbohydrate is the fuel for the body and brain, and mainly it comes in 3 types. That is simple carbohydrates, complex carbohydrates and the fibers. So the simple carbohydrates is further divisible into the monosaccharides. So monosaccharides is nothing but which contain only one type of sugar molecule, such as glucose. So glucose is a blood sugar, and fructose. So fructose is a fruit sugar, and galactose. Galactose is a milk sugar. Okay. So and disaccharides, literally it is divisible into monosaccharides and disaccharides. Okay. So the monosaccharides contains glucose, fructose and galactose, and disaccharides, which are made up of glucose combined with another sugar. So these, the three primary disaccharides are maltose, lactose and sucrose. So which is the most people mean by sugar, right? So the complex carbohydrates or starch is a polysaccharide, because the body must break these bonds to release the chemical energy and store in them. In some cases, these bonds cannot be broken down by human digestion, as is the case with fiber. So, nutrients are used to produce energy and detecting and responding to environmental surrounding. They are moving, excreting the waste, respiring, growing and reproducing. Everything are working under based on the nutrition we consume. So the fast releasing carbohydrates are consist of two basic units. Okay, that is the simple sugar and it includes the sucrose. These type of sugar you would have in a bowl on a breakfast table, and glucose, the type of sugar that circulates in your blood, right? So 1 gram of carbohydrates yield 4 kilocalories of energy for the cells in the body to perform work. In addition to providing energy and serving as building blocks for bigger macromolecules, carbohydrates are essential for proper functioning of the nervous system, heart and kidneys. So as I mentioned, glucose can be stored in the body for future use. In human, the storage of molecule of carbohydrate is called glycogen, and in plants it is known as starches. Okay, so here glycogen and starches are considered as the slow releasing carbohydrates. So here all this classification is based on the number of sugar molecule present in each groups. Then proteins. Proteins are the essential nutrition and also the building blocks of the body. So protein is having its moment and just not in the workout community. So protein is essential for the good health. The protein provides the building blocks of the body, and it is not just for muscles. So every cell from bone to skin to hair contains proteins. The average person's body weight is occupying the 16% of proteins. So protein is used primarily for growth, health and body maintenance. So all of your hormones, antibodies and other important substances are composed of protein. It is not used to fuel the body unless necessary. So proteins are made up of different amino acids which cannot be biosynthesized by the body. Such kind of amino acids are called as essential amino acids. So that can only come from the food. You need a variety of amino acids for your body to function properly, right? So the essential, the 9 essential amino acids are phenylalanine, valine, threonine, tryptophan, methionine, leucine, isoleucine, lysine and histidine. You can pronounce with me: phenylalanine, valine, threonine, tryptophan, methionine, leucine, isoleucine, lysine and histidine. These are the 9 essential amino acids which cannot be synthesized by our body. We have to take it through foods. So what kind of foods giving the essential amino acids? Meat, fish, and eggs are the good source of essential amino acids. You can also get protein from plant sources like beans, soya beans, nuts, and also some grains. Exactly how much protein you need daily depend on a variety of factors including how active you are and your age. So here, the food sources of protein come from animals such as meats, dairy products, seafoods, and a variety of different types of plants-based foods. So here, the word protein comes from a Greek word which means of primary importance, which is an apt description of these macronutrients. They are also colloquially as known as workhorses of life. So proteins provide 4 kilograms of energies. However, providing energy is not protein's most important function. The scientists have estimated that greater than 100,000 of different protein exist within the human body. Then, fats. Fats in the diet provides energy. They maintain cell structures and are involved in metabolic functions. Fats is otherwise called as lipids. So lipids are also a family of molecule which is composed of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. But unlike carbohydrates, they are insoluble in water. This class of molecules may be visible, for example, vegetable oil, or invisible, for example, cream in the food you eat. So fats are found predominantly in butter, oils, meats, dairy products, nuts and seeds, and in many processed foods. So there are two types of fats, essential and non-essential fatty acids, which cannot be synthesized in the body and we have to provide it through the diet. The essential fatty acids required in human nutrition are omega fatty acids. So the three main types of lipids are called as triglycerides, that is phospholipids, sterols and triglycerides. Okay, so the main job of lipid is to store energy. So lipids are providing more energy per gram than carbohydrates, that is 9 kilocalories per gram of lipids versus 4 kilograms of carbohydrates. In addition to the energy storage, lipids serves as a cell membranes, surrounds and protect organs, aid in temperature regulation and regulate many other functions in the body. The main job of lipids is to store energy. Okay, so lipids provide more energy per gram than carbohydrates. In addition to energy storage, lipids serves as cell membrane. It is surrounding and protecting the organs. So lipids is also considered as healthy fats in your diet. It can help you to balance your blood sugar level. When the fat gets decreased, the risk of heart disease, that is, and also you may face the type 2 diabetes. They are also powerful anti-inflammatories and they may lower your risk of arthritis, cancers and Alzheimer's disease. Okay. So the dietary guidelines recommend you to that 20-35% of your daily calories come from fat. But the WHO suggests keeping it under 30% of your calories. Yes, fat is high in calories, but those calories are an important energy source of your body. Then, vitamins. So, vitamins are the vital nutrition required in minute quantities to perform specific physiological and biochemical functions. So, there are 13 vitamins. And it is an organic compound which is based on carbon. Either they may be water soluble vitamin or a fat soluble vitamins. The water soluble vitamins are vitamin C and all the vitamins of B, which include thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, pantothenic acid, pyridoxine, biotin, folate and cobalamin. Okay, so the fat soluble vitamins are A, vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. So vitamins are required to perform many functions in the body, which is used for regulatory or either the metabolic capacity, such as making red blood cells, synthesizing bone tissue, and also it is playing a role in normal vision and also nervous system function and immune system function. So some functions in the chemical reactions involved in the release of energy from carbohydrates of proteins, fats and alcohols. So the vitamins do not supply directly, which is do not supplying the energy directly, and it is also not structural one. They enable some chemical reactions to occur. So vitamins are the warding of disease and staying healthy. So the body needs these micronutrients to support its function. Each vitamins play an important role in the body, and not getting enough of them can cause health problems and diseases. So vitamins are essential for skin and bones and also for vision. So vitamins may lower the risk of lung and prostate cancer. They are a powerful antioxidants. So vitamins like vitamin C, boosting the immune system and helps the body to heal. If you eat a varied, well-balanced diet full of vegetables and fruits and have a normal and healthy functioning digestive tract, you likely don't need to take vitamin supplements. Then minerals. Minerals are inorganic substances that is required as an essential nutrition by organism to perform various biological functions necessary for life. So they are also the constituent of teeth, bones, tissues, blood muscles and nerve cells. So minerals are solid inorganic substances that form crystals that are classified depending on how much of them we need. There are trace minerals such as molybdenum, selenium, zinc, iron and iodine are only required in a few milligrams or less, and macro minerals such as calcium, magnesium, potassium, sodium and phosphorus are required in hundreds of milligrams. So the macro minerals required by the human body are calcium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium and magnesium. So the micro minerals required by the human body are called as trace elements, which we require in a very minute quantities are sulfur, iron, chlorine, cobalt, copper, zinc, manganese, molybdenum, iodine and selenium. So mineral function in structural, regulatory and metabolic capacities. They are also involving in building of bones and teeth, which are the main example of a structural function, while maintaining fluid balance, building bone tissues, synthesizing hormones, transmitting nerve impulse, contraction and relaxation of muscles, and protecting against harmful free radicals are the example of regulatory and metabolic process. So minerals are not supplying the energy directly. Okay, so if we consume the sodium, which is maintaining the fluid balance, nerve transmission and muscle contraction, and the sulfur is playing a major role in protein production, and the calcium is regulating the bone and teeth health maintenance, and it is also nerve transmission, muscle contraction and blood clotting. So much like vitamins and minerals helping supporting the body, in addition to strengthen bones, calcium help with nerve signal transmission, maintaining the blood pressure, where the zinc boosts your immune system and wound healing. I would like to tell you few points about water, which is also acting as a major nutrition. So this is one other nutrition that we must have in large quantities. Water does not contain carbon, but it is composed of two hydrogens and one oxygen per molecule of water. More than 60% of your total body weight is water. Without it, nothing could be transported in or out of the body. Chemical reactions would not occur. Organs would not be cushioned. Joints would not be lubricated, and body temperature would fluctuate widely. On average, an adult consumes just over 2 liters of water per day from food and drink. According to the rules of threes, a generalization supported by survival experts, a person can survive 3 minutes without oxygen, 3 days without water, and 3 weeks without food. Since water is so critical for life's basic processes, the amount of water input and output is supremely important. So we have to drink 3 liters of water per day for the healthy life. You can go for weeks without food, but you cannot last more than a few days without water. So water is absolutely crucial for every system in your body. So water improves your brain function and mood. It acts as a shock absorber and a lubricant in the body. It helps to flush out toxins, carry nutrition to the cells, hydrate the body, and prevent constipation. Even mild dehydration can make you feel tired and impair your concentration and physical performance. You don't have to use water to stay hydrated. Fruits and vegetables can also be great source. Munch on some spinach or watermelon to stay hydrated. The best way to know if you are properly hydrated is the color and volume of your urine. If your urine isn't frequent and pale yellow or nearly clear, you need more water. So I have included some do you knows, which is in your textbook. We'll take a look on that. So the first one is, Dr. Funk introduced the term vitamin. Vitamin A was given the first letter of the alphabet, as it was the first vitamin discovered. So Dr. Funk is the one who discovered, who named the vitamins, vitamin A. So since vitamin A is the first vitamin he found and the first alphabet is A, so he named the vitamin A. So the next one is, human skin can synthesize vitamin D when exposed to sunlight. I think you might have known this fact already. So especially early morning. So when the sun rays fall on the skin, what happens? The dehydrocholesterol, which is lying under your skin, is converted into vitamin D. That is, your unwanted cholesterols are getting melted in the form of vitamin D. Hence, vitamin D is also called as sunshine vitamin. Vitamin D improves your bone strength by helping body to absorb calcium. So vitamin D is the very, very important. The people, those who are going for walking or jogging in the sunlight, they might have get vitamin D directly from the sunlight. So keep your health, keep your body in a healthy way. Okay, gain some vitamins and minerals in a healthy way. Thank you, students. Glucose.